Hi, I'm Dr. Janice Huntingford, and I'm an integrative veterinarian. I wanted to talk to you today about a condition that we see in dogs mostly, called hyperadrenocorticism, also known as Cushing's disease. Now, it is a very common endocrine disease that is diagnosed mostly in older dogs. So what causes this? Well, in general, it's caused by a small benign tumor at the base of the brain in the pituitary. Occasionally, it's caused by a tumor in the adrenal gland itself. Or we may see it caused iatrogenically. The word iatrogenic means doctor caused, and that could be caused if for some reason the dog was given too much prednisone or too much other cortisone for, say, a skin condition. And then we can cause Cushing's disease with the medication. So what are the signs that people see with Cushing's disease in their dogs? Well, sometimes they don't really see anything and it's picked up on a routine blood test. But the classic signs of Cushing's disease are increased drinking, increased urination, increased appetite, development of a pot belly, and usually some hair loss problems, generally along the side or a thinning of the undercoat of the dog. As things progress, you can have an issue with the heart. You can also get muscle weakness, and the dog can become absolutely ravenous and is really drinking and really peeing quite a bit. And so the owners get quite upset about this. And generally, if they haven't taken the dog to the veterinarian at that time, they're taking it. Now, it can take a little bit to diagnose Cushing's. There's several tests that need to be run, but once something is already confirmed with Cushing's disease, then your veterinarian will talk to you about treatment. Now, the conventional treatment for Cushing's disease is a medication called trilastine, and trilastine affects the adrenal glands and virtually shuts off the adrenal glands from producing cortisone. And this may be very helpful if the dog's producing excess cortisone, but sometimes it goes a little too far and you can end up with a dog who has too little cortisone. And the signs of too little cortisone can be devastating and even fatal if the dog has very, very little cortisone and then it has a condition called Addison's disease. But anyway, as an integrative practitioner, I am more inclined to treat dogs who have hyperadrenocorticism with herbals. And there was a great paper that came out of the University of Tennessee about treating these patients using melatonin and flaxseed lignans. Now, I do like to use both of those things in my Cushing's cases. I also add milk thistle, and I will also add Pet Well-Being's Adrenal Harmony. I like the Adrenal Harmony because it helps to balance the Cushing's. It basically helps to balance the adrenal glands so that they aren't producing too much cortisol, but they aren't producing too little cortisol as well. The other things that are in the Adrenal Harmony are supporting the body. So there's antioxidants in there, and they're very, very much to help support the body and to support the liver. So if you are having a problem with your dog and it has Cushing's disease and you're concerned about treating it with a pharmaceutical, then I would consider treating it with melatonin, flaxseed lignans, milk thistle, and Pet Well-Being's Adrenal Harmony. As an integrative practitioner, that's how I would do it. Thanks for your attention. See you next time.